Alafu wacha pamoja smoky.
Zote pamoja.
Eh, zote pamoja smoky mbili.
A day in the life of selling popular African street food, Kenyan Smocha. It is known, very well known, with the Kenyan youngins, the youth, the millennium Smocha, aka Rolex of Uganda, but in a Kenyan way. So life in Kenya, African food, and today we're gonna be going to sell exactly at the smoky joint, my best smoky joint, aka Kasarani Hunters. Smash that like button if you want to enjoy this kind of videos. And this video, I want to throw a major shout out to Jasmine Ama, my Ghanaian, butcher me in the comments. Jasmine Ama, my Ghanaian sister, she highly inspired this video. And yeah, thank you so much, my sister, if you're watching. Asante sana. Okay, enjoy the video. Welcome back to today's video. My name is Kemunto and today I have a guest here.
John Kamau. My name is John Kamau.
Yeah.
A small vendor of smoky in my eye.
Yes.
Hunter's feet.
Yes.
Yeah.
So in today's video, we are going to do a day in the life of John selling smoky and my eye.
Alafu wacha pamoja smoky.
Zote pamoja.
Eh, zote pamoja.
And how is corona affecting
your
business?
Corona. Business in various ways. Mm-hmm. The working hours were mostly affected by imposition of curfew. Curfew. Coffee became a major challenge. Because you see, during a few hours, this when there is rush. There is plenty of gateway. There is plenty of people moving around. And then you find that the duration that you should be working
now,
yeah, it's less, yeah. The hours that you are working, it's less. Now that's the major challenge as long as corona is concerned. Yeah. Are doing constant challenges. Some of the challenges that I experience here, maybe long working hours, that's one. Requires a lot of commitment. This job requires a lot of we tend to employ people.
What can you change in your life or in the world, or what impact do you feel you can change the world?
That's a relevant question.
Mm-hmm.
Following my ideology or the line of thought, mm-hmm. is William Ruto's thought,
mm-hmm.
that we should impact on the economic model of this country.
Mm-hmm.
We need to start from the bottom.
Mm-hmm.
Let's raise the small scale vendors who are at the bottom and raise them at the top. With that economic model, we are likely to improve our economic state as per now. What I can say, if we small-scale farmers small-scale businesses, we get some support from the government, maybe we go and take a loan and start a small-scale business. And the methods or the mechanisms that should be used to access these loans, they should not be hectic as it is for now, because you find that you may have the capability of going and borrow some money or loan or take some loan somewhere, but you get that the concepts that the government requires for you to set up or for you to borrow that money it's hectic at times. Mm-hmm. You waste a lot of time. Mm-hmm. Maybe you don't have you're not informed on how to.
So what time do you open your business?
As any other business, I do wake up very early in the morning. Mm-hmm. I prepare myself. Mm-hmm. I take my breakfast. Mm-hmm. I communicate with my wholesalers, mm-hmm. my business partners in these smokies and knives. Mm-hmm. I get them, I prepare them, mm-hmm. and then I start off my business maybe at around 8 or 9 in the morning.
You start your business. Yeah, yeah. And how has Corona affected your business?
Corona affected me greatly. Let me say greatly. Mm-hmm. Because for one, the moment curfew was imposed, mm-hmm. the number of hours reduced. That's mm-hmm. one. Mm-hmm. So some of the customers vacated from this area. That's a major reason also. That's a major challenge. Mm-hmm. As long as Corona is concerned. Mm-hmm. Most of the customers were fired from their jobs, mm-hmm. and they were daily customers. I used to generate more money
when they were working.
Yeah, while they were working. Mm-hmm. But the moment they got fired, some went back to urban areas, mm-hmm. to rural areas, mm-hmm. and as a result, my business was affected.
Oh, okay. Yeah. And the hours, how long do you work with
before?
Yeah, before and after, Corona.
Before Corona, I used to work for around 15 hours in a day. Uh-huh. 15 hours in a day. After Corona, mm-hmm. maybe around how many hours? From 9 to 10. Oh. That's around 11 hours. So my number of hours, working hours has been greatly affected by this problem. Yeah.
So what do you do for a living?
This is my main business.
Main business.
That I do. Although mm-hmm. there is another side also that I do.
But this one is the main. Okay. Yeah. Do you have family?
Yeah, I have a family. Mm-hmm. I have a kid and a wife. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and I pay my bills mainly through this small scale business. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And how is it so far?
So far, I can't complain as much, mm-hmm. because I'm making sales as usual. Mm-hmm. Yeah, but if the number of hours can be increased. Yeah, maybe improve my facility, because I want to improve my facility. Yeah. I also want to improve my services and the likes, and I know that will be achieved.
So what do you fear about the world, or about Kenya, or about anything that actually when you wake up it you get fear?
Mostly I fear during this period, mostly I fear the policemen at night. They are very hostile. They can come and bribe your money that you have worked for the whole day. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So if there is good relationship between us and the policeman, as per now, mm-hmm. I think I can feel comfortable. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. What do you love?
I love politics. Let me say I like watching politic clips. I like following politicians. I mm-hmm. like following their line of thought.
So you are so pumped up about the election 2022.
I'm so pumped, yeah.
Yeah, sure. You have no fear. Just
because that's my interest. Wow. That's where my interest lies. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Chama so, gani? Kama, well, that's too personal.
Kama kawaida mimi hasla mdogo. I go for UDA, United Democratic Alliance. That will be my party. Yeah.
So what is one thing you'll change about maybe your life or the world or Kenya? What thing would you change if you had a power to change anything?
Okay, if there is something that I would like to change, mm-hmm. as long as our nation or country is concerned, mm-hmm. let me start discussing.
Okay.
And how to gather the money or how to acquire the money. So if we ease in the process of acquiring loans from the government and the like, I think the process will improve. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And what's your view on unemployment rate in Kenya?
My view in unemployment rate in Kenya, I can tell most of the youths, because this mainly hits the youths.
Yeah.
I can tell them that it's not a must that you are in office or you should be
employed.
Or you should be employed. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I think if you are open-minded, there are opportunities here. You can do anything. You can do anything. Mm-hmm. And if you create passion in it, God will bless you and customers will appreciate you.
He has a customer can take care of. Your microphone on the phone is the best because the phone is for calling, so microphone is the important thing. Try to look for a job,
yes,
or
try
other businesses before.
I mean,
this business. Your experience on that?
Yeah, thanks. Yeah, I tried. I tried many jobs. I tried various jobs without success. Yeah? But the moment this job came into my idea, I developed some interest. I looked at my area very nicely. I tried to view on a strategic position because this job was not quite common here by then. So the moment I started, I even attracted more traders. More traders in the same sector. So
the original one.
Yeah,
on this trip.
But due to various challenges that one encounter in this area, they just give up.
So that's why you have to be passionate.
You must develop patience and passion
and consistency.
And also you must give thanks to God. Must say a word of thanks to him. Also, I thank my customers for the support.
I'm also one of your customers.
Sure. Being among them in your family also.
Yes. So what? How can I say? Can you encourage other people to start this business? Like,
Yeah, it might not be similar.
But you just need to be patient, consistent, and passionate. Yeah. Those three things.
In everything that you do. And
yeah, that's true.
You know, the moment you have passion in something, you like it. You like what you do.
Even if there's challenges, you struggle to surpass them.
An elder. So, first of all, I would like to thank my customers.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, my customers, everywhere you are, maybe watching this video, you are welcome at my place. Secondly, I would like to greet my wife, Adasa, my kid Scarlett, my mom at home, and my dad, my brothers also, Akina Sam, Simon, Peter. I say hi to them.
Thank you, Sana, for having us.
I would also like to thank you.
Thank you too.
Continue encouraging more small scale vendors to have those values that I have.
Patience,
consistency, and passion.
Same as also on YouTube.
Thank you.
Thanks a lot.
Thanks, Sana.
Yeah,
my
farmer's choice.
Nikai, you come and Nikai side.
Nikai
side. Nikango smoky person. Na chapo. This is a very common street food, most loved by Kenyans, especially
bachelors
and our engineers who should be at the park.
Kula tu naiona kula.
So for people who are not familiar with this, it's a smoky, it's a pork sausage, you know, the pork sausage,
beef.
It's a beef sausage, and then you put in a favorite salad, Kenyan salad with tomatoes and onions and ketchup. Tomato sauce, not ketchup. So guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this kind of videos and if you like for me to continue with this series, give this video a thumbs up, comment and share. So if you want to buy smokies, they are the best, but they have eaten them for ever since I lived here. It's in Hunters Road, Kasarani. So if you're ever here, pop up by John's place and eat smokies. Just located at the street. Small chance available.
Thank you.
Bye.